We are at Nyanga District Hospital catching up on the current ITU telemedicine project that has been officially launched a few minutes back by the Honourable Minister of ICT, Postal and Courier Services, Honourable Sue Mandwanze. Joined with us right here at Nyanga District Hospital, we've got the District Medical Officer, Dr. Edmond Jagiro, and also accompanied by him, we've got Sister Rosemary Chikai. Thank you so much for being on our short YouTube video. Right, I understand that a few minutes back we were watching the live sessions whereby you were actually speaking to real patients with the real medical issues. How is this process managed to help your implementation of the whole telemedicine offline consultation?
Okay, I think you may be aware of the challenges that we do have in our system in terms of access to healthcare. And when we talk of access to healthcare, we talk of the availability of the institutions for people to get treated. We also talk of the availability of human resources in those institutions for them to be able to manage the patients. We also need medicines to be available in the institutions. But one other thing is also we want the people to actually be able to get to the institutions where there will be these practitioners. So one of the things which is really key and topical in this part of the country is the inability for people to find perhaps a simple journey to come to the district hospital or to get to the clinic. So the use of ICTs has enabled patients who previously had to travel journeys where they would have to part with $10 to $20 or sometimes 3-4 hours drive to be able to get to a clinic or to the hospital. Now we can be able to remotely manage these patients. So obviously one of the biggest benefits has been the cost savings part of on the part of the patients.
And the patients themselves, how acceptable is this technology? I understand that we are coming from a background where people would want to physically get to see the doctor. How is it acceptable for people to say, I'm going to be consulting a doctor via a screen?
I think initially we thought that as well in our minds. We actually thought that there could be resistance, perhaps because of people not being aware of technology or just apprehension, things like that. But what we've discovered is actually it's actually contrary to what beliefs we actually held ourselves. The people have actually embraced the technology, and we do have patients who are getting to clinics demanding from the nurses that they actually want to see the doctor on Skype or on the television screen, when sometimes their conditions would actually be managed by the nurses. So that alone is an expression of how people have actually embraced. But actually, you may also know that even when we are calling ourselves as colleagues or as our social individuals, we are using voice telephone calls, and we do accept that the person at the other end, because we recognize their voice and things like that, but we actually talk and make transactions and agreements. So now that this is enhanced through video, I think it has made them more comfortable, because really the nurse at the clinic is with them in the room, and they are talking to doctors whose names they know or whose voices they actually previously recognized from previous interactions. So generally the community is accepted and embraced the technology.
Mm-hmm. I understand that nationally this has only been launched in Nyanga region. How many hospitals or clinics are you connected to, as you said?
As we speak, we have two connected clinics that are live and online every day. But within the next few coming days, with the Portras ITU project, we are now extending to 6 clinics within the district. Another district is going to be connected as well, Chimanimani.
Okay. How is the distance? What is the furthest, rather, from here to the next clinic that you're going to be connected to?
Okay, within the upcoming project which I'm talking about, we have a clinic which is as far as 150 kilometers, which is right at the border between Nyanga and Mutsi. We also have another clinic which is about 120 kilometers away. We have two others which I think are about 80 kilometers away. But really, when you talk of this distance in terms of mileage, you may think that these clinics are not so far. We also talk of terrain here in Nyanga. You are going up hills, the roads are bumpy. Yes, they've been affected by the rains and they've not been well maintained. So one of these clinics, the one which is 150 kilometers away, it takes about 4 hours to actually drive a single trip to get to the clinic.
Mm. Well, which may even discourage the patients to come all the way through.
Yes, and you can imagine this is a patient who is in pain or his blood pressure is very high or they have high blood sugar. They have not yet been able to get an intervention. So when you come in now with this technology, you allow even to have pre-referral treatment. The patient can be stabilized whilst the ambulance is actually going to go and pick the patient. And in future, we actually envisage a scenario where even our ambulances can have these ICT devices within them, so that even as the patient is actually being transported whilst coming back to the hospital, we can actually be communicating with the nurse who will be on the ambulance.
Let's talk just a bit on the technology surrounding this whole project. I understand that we saw a last live session where you were speaking to the patients. What kind of a connectivity are you looking into? How are they connected from the other side, and how are you also connected from this side?
Okay, so for internet connectivity, we are using ADSL, VSAT, and also GSM systems, 3G and 4G from NetOne. Mm-hmm. So that is allowing us to establish connectivity within the clinics. So when depending on the available connection, we can interchangeably use the satellite in the third generation and fourth generation systems. But we also actually do tend to have better connectivity when we are using the 3G and 4G. So it is actually our hope that government or the people who are driving this project would be able to use even the fourth generation mobile because we have greater speeds and lesser latency when we are using 4G. Mm-hmm.
So basically that means you've got tier 1 and net 1 supporting the infrastructure.
Definitely. This we are using connectivity being supplied by tier 1 and net 1.
Okay. Let's just talk about the other services that you think may be needed, because I'm seeing that you are probably supplementing quite well on the teleconferencing, that is you speaking to the patients. Are we going to be seeing other first world technologies like remote scanning, remote testing, checking and all that stuff that can be done by a doctor who's not necessarily in the same geographical limitations?
Yes, I can certainly tell you that within this upcoming project, which is being funded by Portras and ITU, those components have actually been catered for and they are budgeted for. So we are going to see the deployment of medical peripheral equipment, which is high tech, which can allow the remote ultrasound, remote electrocardiograph, X-rays to be done, and these images can then be sent to the doctor, who can then interpret these images without the patient necessarily having to move to be able to take to have these things done. And I can also tell you that even Minister Mandwanzi is actually keen to actually see the deployment of these pieces of equipment within the system. Mm-hmm.
The human resource behind this whole thing. You are a trained nurse, the technological stuff. How easy is it for you coming as a nurse with a nursing background to know and understand all these things?
Yeah, we need some trainings on the computers, how to use the computer so that it will become easier. If you don't have a technological background, it will be very difficult. So we need some trainings. Mm-hmm.
How much has the government managed to put in to fund this whole project so far as it stands?
In terms of the upcoming pilot, the budget is well up to $400,000 to be able to take care of the two districts, mm-hmm. Nyanga and Chimanimani.
Mm-hmm. Okay, just before we shut down this short interview, how do you see the future of telemedicine and all these technologies? Do you think that they're sustainable? Do you think that they're going to be able to impact the people of Zimbabwe, especially the rural population that we have here?
I think there's no doubt that as we go into the future, we are going to see more and more technology being deployed within the way we dispense our daily activities. I think even outside the medical field, we know that people are already talking of driverless cars. We know how we're exchanging money, e-commerce, sending money via the mobile systems. We know how shopping, we are doing our shopping online, ordering, and things are being delivered. So it's no longer a question of whether ICTs can actually help in the health sector, but it's about how we can have ICTs helping in the health sector. So it's a question of us, medical practitioners, our nurses here, looking at various ICT tools which can improve the way we deliver our services, embracing them and using them. Otherwise, the truth is that if somebody will be thinking that technology cannot get into the healthcare services or trying to stop technology in the health services, it will be like trying to stop a tsunami. It is inevitable that we will be using ICTs more and more as we go into the future, because they will only be able to make our work easier. We will be using lesser human resources, saving time, saving money.
You heard it all from Dr. Tokiro with the Nyanga District Hospital. Thank you so much for taking your time to do our short technical YouTube video. Hope to see you soon.